So I've had this heat pump installed for over a month now, and we've got a full calendar month of experience with it. During that period, there was a pretty good cold snap for a week, so we know how it performs now. So I thought I'd share with you in this video a few things that we had to do since the installation, what it's been like to live with for that first month, and then we'll finish with some energy data and costs to see how it compared to running the old gas boiler. But first, let's start by doing a bit of a noise test and see what the noise levels are like. So the same as I did before with the gas boiler, I'm going to take a background noise reading using my Apple Watch. So it's just the built-in noise app on the watch. So if I'm going to be quiet for a few seconds, I'll start filming on my phone so as you can see what's going on. So 36 decibels it reckons, so let's fire up the heat pump and see what the noise levels are like then. Right, now it's all fired up. And I don't know if you can hear it. I'm standing slightly back from being directly in front of the fan just because of the wind noise. It is making a noise. It's a definite rumbly fan noise, but I'm now about a meter away from it. So I'm gonna take another noise reading using the exact same process. So it reckons about 39 decibels at 1 meter away. Now, it is quite a mild day, and when it gets really cold, this thing will ramp up and be even noisier. But this is quite a typical sort of noise level for what it's like when it's in general use. So do you remember this from a previous video? This is the vent that's covering up the old gas flue from the boiler. Now, I took my previous noise reading for the boiler about here, floating in midair, which was 1 meter away from the gas flue. So I'm going to do the exact same thing again, and we're going to find out what the noise levels are like for the heat pump, which is around the corner over there, in the same position that I measured the gas boiler from. So let's have a listen. So it says 36 or 37 decibels, and I can hear it. I'm not denying that, and sometimes it can be a lot noisier than that, but to be honest, that means it's pretty much no noisier than the general background of birds and aeroplanes and things that are going over anyway. One of the biggest jobs I had to do when they'd finished the installation was sort out boxing out of the pipework out here. So you can see the flow and return pipes go into the fascia board. So I've had to put on new fascia board and sort of box it out at a lower level to where it was before. And if I pan across here, you can see there's a step change where it goes back up to the original level. That's because I was being a bit lazy. I didn't want to actually adjust the whole drain pipe, and I couldn't be bothered with getting new fascia board extensions on the end of it either. I'm quite pleased with the job I've done. I think it's quite a neat job, apart from one little bit here, which I will show you, that I'm still not happy with. I couldn't quite support it properly underneath, so I had to put a bit of a bracket on there. That needs tidying up, and I've not worked out how to do that yet. I've also rebuilt the shelves for my cats, because there were two shelves there originally where that water tank was, and they ran the sort of full length of this shot that you can see here. So now they've got shorter shelves, but there are three. So there's one at the top for one of the cats to sleep in, and then two lower ones for them to eat. So if you remember our airing cupboard from before where we had the hot water tank, I've fitted some shelves back into there, but in a different position, and also put some old carpet down here on the floor just to make it a bit neater. So what has it been like to live with then? Well, the house has been very warm. Consistently warm is the big difference. With the gas boiler and Evo Home, I was only heating selected rooms on a varying schedule. So the living room would be nice and warm, but you'd walk into the kitchen and it would be much cooler. Now though, every room in the house is warm. It's also a lot quieter in the house. There's no clunking from the pipes heating up and cooling down. No swooshing sounds from the pump because the airing cupboard has been emptied, and we no longer hear the immersion heater either in the middle of the night. Generally, the house is very warm and quiet. It's balanced nicely. I've put temperature sensors in every room, mostly Aqara Zigbee ones. And using Home Assistant, I'm monitoring the warm-up of the rooms and they're all getting up to temperature at about the same time. It takes a bit of getting used to because it does take longer to heat the house. So I used to set the heating to come on at about 6 o'clock in the morning so as it'd be 20 degrees by 7 o'clock. But now I need to give it an extra hour, and even then on cold mornings, it won't get there before everyone has left for the day. I don't want it to come on any earlier though, because otherwise the house would be too hot while we're trying to sleep. In the evenings though, it has longer to warm up, so it works very well. There have been a couple of problems. There was a leak from the compression fitting on a radiator in the bathroom. That started a couple of weeks after the install, and I think it had just worked loose from the temperature changes. I didn't call anyone out for that and tightened it up myself. Then there was another leak that I found under my utility sink, where they joined the hot and cold water pipes to my existing circuits. It had been dripping very slowly into some plastic drawers that I'd fitted. Luckily, the drawers had caught all of the water, and they were full of sponges too, which had absorbed a lot. I called Octopus out and they visited within 24 hours and fixed it. It looks like when they did the work, the screw fitting on the tap connector under the sink had come slightly loose, so nothing major. I can't really fault the aftercare there at all. While I'm on the subject of Octopus Energy, you don't need to be with them for your energy supply to use them for a heat pump install. But if you did want to switch to them for your energy, then please use my referral code, which is on the screen right now. If you use that, then we'll both get £50 of account credit once your switch to them has completed. Back to the issues though, and then there was also that problem of the slow flowing radiator in the dining room. Now, I don't know if the issue is still there or whether it was solved by changing the valves. Nobody's checked. That there's no issue with the radiator heating up and the room gets up to temperature at the same speed as the rest of the house. I made the decision to not have that investigated further because I felt it wasn't really worth digging holes in my walls to fix a problem that isn't causing issues. Let's be honest, this bit is probably what you're here for. How much did it cost to run my heat pump in January? And did it cost more or less than my gas boiler? Well, I've got a lot of data to show you here. Let's start off with a comparison to my gas usage from last January. This is raw energy data per day comparing January last year on the gas boiler, which is the red line, against energy used by the heat pump this January, which is the green line. I don't think it will come as any surprise to see that the heat pump used a lot less energy every day because it's over 300% efficient. But electricity does of course cost more per unit than gas, so we need to compare the costs. Keeping the same colours here, red is the gas cost and green is the heat pump cost. Now I've taken January last year's usage for gas but costed it using the flexible Octopus gas price for January this year, which is 7.57 pence per kilowatt hour. Then, for heat pump costs, I've used the flexible Octopus standard rate of 28.71 pence per kilowatt hour. The problem here with comparing last year's usage against this year though, is that we had a real decent cold snap. You can see the green line jump right up in the middle of the month when the temperature dropped below freezing. Another problem with comparing my heating energy this year to my heating last year is that my Evo Home system didn't heat all rooms at the same time, so I tuned it to use as little gas as possible. The heat pump, however, heats my whole house evenly, so it's far more comfortable now, and the gas usage from last year doesn't include hot water heating either, which was done by an immersion heater off peak. So let's see if we can get a more accurate picture of what January should have cost then. Here we have the total cost for gas based on last January's usage, but costed at this January's rates, represented by the red bar. You can see that's about £111. Bolted onto the top of that is the amount I spent on heating the hot water, which was about 4 kilowatt hours per day, and I've costed that at the Octopus Go off-peak rates for fairness. That's 9 pence per kilowatt hour, which is almost comparable cost-wise to if I'd used gas. So my predicted monthly cost for heating my home using gas in January is about £146. But I think I need some way to verify that figure as being in the right ballpark. Heat pumps obviously use electrical energy to generate heat energy. So if I look at how much heat energy was generated by the heat pump in January, then I can work out how much that would have cost me in gas. Assuming here that the boiler is 90% efficient, which mine definitely wasn't anywhere near close, using January's flexible Octopus gas rate again, that energy would have cost me £157. So similar ballpark to last year, but slightly increased due to that cold snap. And let's compare that to how much that energy would have cost me if I was paying the flexible Octopus electricity rate of 28.71 pence per kilowatt hour. That works out at £144. So there's a slight saving there from using the heat pump over the gas boiler, but the important thing here is that they are roughly similar. This isn't the Rolls-Royce of heat pumps, it's a budget installation, but it's still quite clear that it does not cost more to run than a gas boiler. In fact, it would be very slightly cheaper. This is therefore the maximum it would cost to run, because if you have a heat pump, then you really are best off switching to a smart tariff that gives you cheaper energy rates at certain times of the day. Maybe you could sign up with Octopus Cozy, which would reduce that monthly cost further, making it even cheaper to run than the gas boiler. I use Octopus Go because I have an EV, but I also have home batteries that I charge off-peak at the same time. That means that the majority of my energy use, and therefore my heating, uses off-peak rates. This is the